Welcome to the Python programming specialization. In the last lecture, we have discussed Python variables, objects, and literals. In this lecture, we'll discuss various Python operators. We'll see what operators are, what operands are, and in addition, what are the various types of operators supported by Python. In addition, in detail, we'll discuss arithmetic operators, relational operators, logical operators, and the bitwise operators that are supported by Python. So now let's try to understand what operators and operands are. Operators are basically the symbols that denotes an operation in any programming language. So if you consider in mathematical terms, we use plus as a symbol to denote the addition operation. Similarly, we use minus to denote the subtraction operation. And whereas the cross symbol is used to denote the multiplication operation, and the horizontal bar is used to denote the division operation. And Python also has different symbols for denoting various operations. These operators cannot work on their own, and they need either values or objects to be performed. So if you consider this example operation A plus B here, plus is the symbol which denotes the addition operation, and the operation is applied on these variables A and B. So that's how A and B are the operands in this operation, whereas the plus symbol is the operator. Similarly, consider X minus Y. In this case, minus is the operator, X and Y are the variables which denote the operands in this operation. So consider this example A plus 10. Here plus is the operator, whereas A and 10, A is a variable and 10 is the constant, they act as operands in this addition operation. So now consider another operation 100 plus 200, which denotes the addition of the constants 100 and 200. In this operation, 100 and 200 act as operands. So now we understand that in an operation, for example, A plus B, so this is an example operation. Here, the plus is a symbol which denotes the operator, as it denotes the operation that is to be performed here. Whereas A and B are the variables, or they even could be the values that involved in the operation on which the operation is performed. So these are denoted as operands in the operation. So now let's see how the operators are divided into categories depending on the number of operands involved in the operation. So depending on the number of operands involved in the operation, operators could be divided into unary, binary, and ternary. So unary operators means, so they involve in an operation where there is only one unique operand. So in case of the binary operators, there are two different operands involved in the operation. In case of the ternary operators, so the operation involves three different operands. So that's how operators can be divided into unary, binary, and ternary operators. So to perform various operations, Python supports numerous sets of operators. Depending on the types of operators, they are classified as arithmetic, relational, assignment, identity, bitwise, membership, and the logical operations. So now these are all the sets of operations that are supported by Python. Similar to other programming languages like C, C++, Java, C#. So all these languages supports most of these operations except the membership and the identity operators. These two are the sets of operators. The identity and the membership operators are the special operators that are introduced in Python. So in this lecture, we'll discuss each of these types of operators in detail. Now let's try to understand how Python supports various arithmetic operators. So these are all the operations that come under the category of arithmetic operations, like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, integer division, remainder, and even exponent. So these are all the operations that you call them as the arithmetic operations. To support these operations, Python supports these symbols. So like plus for addition, minus for subtraction. So we use cross symbol to denote the multiplication operation in mathematics, right? But here we use the asterisk symbol to denote the multiplication operation, whereas slash is used for the division operation, and double slash operator is used for integer division, whereas the percent symbol is used for the remainder operation, and two asterisk symbols are used to denote the exponent operation. So now let's see with an example how to use these operators and the operations. Let A value as 20 and B value as 3. Now, if you consider the simple arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, they can be used like this. So, A plus B, which indicates that 20 plus 3, which results in 23. Similarly, A minus B, which indicates a subtraction operation, 20 minus 3 results in the value 17. So, whereas A into B results in 60. Then A slash B, which indicates the division operation, that is 20 by 3. You remember, it results in the floating point value if it is required. If we are not interested to get the floating point value, we can even get the integer value as a result of the division by using the integer division. So, A slash slash B. So, A double slash B. That operator double slash indicates the integer division operation and which returns the integer value, and it trims off all the places that are after the decimal point and returns only the integer value as a result. So, even Python supports a remainder operator, which allows you to get the remainder value that results in the division operation. So, in the case of A percent B, that denotes the remainder value that is resulted when you apply the division operation on A and B. So, A divided by B results in the remainder 2, that is 20 divided by 3. So, it returns a remainder value of 3. So, that's how we can use the percent symbol to denote the remainder operation. So, whereas two asterisk symbols can be used to denote the exponentiation operation, in this case 20 power of 3, which indicates the value 8000, and it returns that value as a result. So, this is how all the arithmetic operations can be used in case of the Python, and these are all the symbols that are supported as Python arithmetic operators, and the resultant value that is returned by these operations is dependent on the type of values that are used for the operands. So, if you observe the addition, subtraction, multiplication, of course, the operands are integers and the results are also integers, whereas in case of the division, though the operands are integers, resultant value is a floating point value. The result is dependent on the type of value of the operands involved in the operation. Now, let's see how relational operators are supported by Python. So, for comparing or to check a condition, so like equal to, not equal to, greater than equal to, less than equal to. So, to perform all these kind of relational operations, Python supports these symbols. Like two equal to symbols consecutively together can be used to check the comparison equality. So, similarly, inequality can be checked with a not and exclamatory followed by an equal to symbol. So, we know the other symbols very well, like greater than for greater than. So, greater than or equal to for checking whether it is greater than or equal to. Similarly, less than and less than or equal to symbols can be used to check the comparison of the values. So, these relational operators are basically used to check the truthness of conditions, that is to compare the expressions. So, the general form of the relational operation is expression 1 followed by an operator followed by the expression 2. So, in this case, you are checking the truthness of the expression 1 and expression 2. So, when you apply the condition, either a greater than or a less than or equal to, so or whatever the comparison you want to do. Here in this case, 100 greater than 20. So, here we are checking, so whether 100 is greater than 20 or not. So, it's true. So, it is returning a true value as a result. So, in the first case, we have used simple constant values. So, in the second example, we are using the expressions. So, when we use the expressions in the comparison statement, in that case, the expression is evaluated first and then the condition is tested. So, now in the first expression, 100 plus 20, it is evaluated to 120, and then the second expression on the right hand side, it is 200 into 2, it is evaluated to 400, and then on the resultant values 120 and 400, on those resultant values, the condition will be tested. So, 120 is less than 400. So, that is the comparison actually we are making, or simply we can apply the comparison on the variables also. It need not to be the literals or constants. So, it can be applied on the variables also. Here I am checking whether the value available in A and B are equal to or not. So that's how we can use the relational operators. And when you apply the comparison using the relational operators, then the resultant would be a Boolean value. So that is a true or a false value. And now let's see how we use the relational operators in Python using the examples. So let's consider a value as 1 and b value as 2. And when you use the equality operator on a and b, so it compares 1 and 2, and as 1 and 2 are not equal, so it returns a false value. So now let's try to apply not equal to on a and b, which results in a true value. So 1 is not equal to 2, it's true, so it returns a true value. Similarly, greater than can be applied a greater than b, which compares 1 and 2 with a greater than symbol. Of course, it's a false value. So when you use a greater than or equal to symbol, then so whether it is greater than or equal to. So in this case, 1 is 1 and 2, 1 is neither greater than 2 nor equal to 2, hence it returns a false value. Similarly, less than and less than or equal to can also be used. So in this case, in both the cases, because 1 is less than 2, it returns a true value. So that is how various relational operators can be used to compare different expressions or variables or even the values. When you use the comparison operators with the floating point values, you should be little careful. So consider this example, x equal to 0.1 plus 0.2. So in this assignment statement, basically 0.1 is added to 0.2 and that will be assigned to x. We assume that so x value is having 0.3, and later if we require to check the condition, so x equal to 0.3. So we assume that it has to return true value, because x contains, as per our assumption, it should contain 0.3, but here so it's not the value that is residing in x, actually x contains this value. So that's how when you compare x with 0.3, it returns a false value. So that is how you should be little careful when you are using the equality operator with the floating point numbers. So far we have discussed arithmetic and the relational operators. So in case of the relational operators, we can use any of the relational operators to check only one specific condition. So either a is greater than b or not, either 10 is less than 20 or not, either 200 equal to 200 or not. So that's how we can use the relational operators to check the equality or inequality of any of the condition, that to only one specific condition we can check. But in case if I need to check more than one condition, how do I do that? So I can use the logical operators to combine two or more conditions in the programming language. So the general form is the condition 1 followed by an operator followed by condition 2. So here condition 1 could be a combination of expression, operator and the expression, and similarly condition 2 could also be a combination of expression, operator and the expression. So that's how you can combine two or more conditions using the logical operators. And similar to the relational operators, logical operators also returns a Boolean value depending on the condition. So that is true or false value. So consider we have three different conditions. So condition 1, condition 2 and condition 3. So sometimes I might need to check whether all these conditions are resulting in the true value or not. So I want to check whether all the conditions are true or not together. Or sometimes I might need to check whether any of these conditions is true or not. So it is sufficient for me if any one of the condition is true. Or sometimes I might need to take the reverse of the or complement of the given condition. And to do all these three things, Python supports the logical operators AND, OR and NOT. So let's see how we can use them. So AND is the operator, logical operator, which is used to return a true value when all the conditions together are true. So when you are using AND operator with multiple conditions, then if all these conditions are true, then only it returns a true, otherwise it returns a false value. And coming to the OR operator, when you are using OR operator with multiple conditions, then in that case, if any of these conditions is evaluated true, then it returns a true, otherwise it returns a false value. And NOT can be used to flip the result of an expression or a condition. So if the original condition is a true value, then when you use a NOT with that condition, then it returns in a use AND, OR, NOT operators So to combine two or more conditions. So now let's try to understand how we can use these logical operators with simple examples. So let's consider A value as 10, B value is 20 and C value as 30. So now I'm going to use this to combine two different conditions, A is greater than B and C is greater than A. So in this case, so 10 is greater than 20, A is greater than B means 10 is greater than 20, it's false. And check the second condition, C is greater than A. So 30 is greater than 10. So it is true. So though the second condition is true, the first condition is evaluated to false. So false and true. So any one of the condition is false, then it returns a false value only. So it simply results in the logical AND operation on different conditions. So if all the conditions are true, then only it returns a true value, otherwise it's a false value. So in our example, as one of the condition is resulting a false value, it returns a false instead of the true value. And now consider the other example, how R can be used. So here in this case, I'm checking 10 greater than 20 or 30 greater than 10. A is greater than B or C is greater than A. So in this case, the first condition 10 greater than 20 is false, and the second condition 30 is greater than 10 is true. So it is sufficient. If any one of the condition is true, then the OR operation results in a true value. That's how even if the first condition is false also, the second condition is true, so the overall result will be evaluated to true by the OR operation. So consider, how do we use the NOT operation to complement a condition? So I can use the NOT with the condition A greater than B like this. So A is greater than B, 10 is greater than 20. So of course it's a false value. So when I use with the NOT operation, then it returns a true value. So as it is a complementary to the original condition. So that's how we can use AND, OR, NOT as a logical operators, so to combine two or more conditions. So far we have used the conditional operators with two expressions or with two variables or the values. So basically they can be chained with multiple sets of values. So you can use the general form as expression 1, operator 1, expression 2, operator 2, expression 3, so on and so forth. So we can form a chain of these operators, the relational operators, and you can use them. So suppose I want to check two different conditions, A is greater than B and B is greater than C, both I want to use. So usually the general form we follow is, so we use A is greater than B and we check B is greater than C, and then we use a logical operator to connect these two conditions. But Python supports chaining of the relational operators. Instead of using the logical connector, we can straight away use the chaining of the relational operators. We can use A is greater than B is greater than C. So using that, we can achieve the same. So that's how simply we can use the chaining of the relational operators. So not only greater than, we can use any of the relational operators, chain of the relational operators. So what we need to remember is how it is better than using the logical connector is. So in the case of when we use the logical connector, so then A is greater than B. In that case, A is evaluated once, B is evaluated once. And during the check, second expression evaluation also, again B is evaluated, C is evaluated, if at all, if they are the expressions. But whereas if we use the chaining of the operators, in that case A, B and C, all the expressions are evaluated only once. So that's the advantage of using the chaining of relational operators. Other than that, so their working nature is all the same. Either we can use the first form or we can use the chaining of the relational operators. And one thing we need to remember is, so when we use the chain of operators, it indicates that A is greater than B, in turn it is greater than C, but the operation never compares A and C together. It is only comparing A is greater than B, and also it is comparing B is greater than C. It doesn't mean that A is comparing with C. So that's how we can form chaining of the relational operators. So basically, when we use the logical operators, they follow the short circuit evaluation. That is, when we use the logical OR and the logical AND operators, they follow the short circuit evaluation to save the time. So consider this example, A is greater than B and A is greater than C. So in this case, so whenever we are using the AND operation with multiple conditions, then first it checks the left hand side condition, then if at all if it is true, then it proceeds towards the right side conditions and it proceeds towards the right side conditions. If at all, if any one of the left side condition is false, then it never proceeds with the right side conditions, because to get the false value, it is enough to get one of the conditions is false. So whenever it come across as the first false condition, then it stops evaluating and it returns the result. And similarly with the OR also follows the same short circuit evaluation. So here the OR operation returns a true value if at all if one of the conditions is a true. That is, it is sufficient to have one of the condition as true to get the final result as a true. Then if it finds any one of these conditions as a true value, then it stops checking all the conditions on the right hand side and directly it returns the result. So thereby it can save the time. The Python interpreter can save the time by following this kind of short circuit evaluation. So far we have discussed various arithmetic, logical and the relational operators. Now let's see how Python supports various bitwise operators. So these bitwise operators basically operate in bits. That is, Python interpreter treats each operand in this operation as a string of binary digits. That's how the name is given as bitwise operators. The operation is performed in terms of bits. So if you consider the integer 2, it will not be treated as integer 2 while performing the operation, the bitwise operation. So the 2 integer will be treated as a binary form, that is 1, 0. Whereas if you have any operand 5, integer 5, then it is treated as the binary 1, 0, 1. So that is how every operand that you are using in case of the bitwise operation, they will be treated as binary operands and then the operation will be performed. But the final result will be in terms of the integer result only. So let's see. So these are various bitwise operators that are supported by Python. So NOT, AND, OR, XOR, left shift, right shift. So these are all the bitwise operations, and to support all these operations, Python supports various operators like. So the complement symbol can be used with the NOT operation. Then AND symbol can be used for the bitwise AND, plain symbol can be used for the bitwise OR. Similarly, exponent symbol, or we can call it as a caret symbol also, and that symbol can be used with the XOR operation. And the left shift operation, we can use 2 less than symbols, whereas for the right shift operation, we can use 2 greater than symbols for the right shift operation. So that's how Python supports different bitwise operations, and these are all the operators that can be used with the bitwise operations. So now let's see with an example. So how these binary operations can be performed. So let's consider A value is 10 and B value is 5. And instead of directly operating on the integer values, so what the Python interpreter does is, whenever you are using them in the bitwise operation, then first they will be converted to the binary format. So this is the equivalent binary form of A. Then B is also similarly converted to the binary form. Then on these binary formats only, the resultant bitwise operation would be performed. Let's see how the NOT operation is applied. So in case of the NOT operation, it's a unary operator where the NOT operator is applied on only one operand. So here I am applying NOT operation on A, not A. So that is, you are applying NOT with the value 10, because A value is 10. So NOT you are applying with 10. So you are kind of complementing the value that is available in 10. So first A is converted to the binary form, and then so its binary form is complemented, and that result will be again converted back to the integer, so which is equal to minus 11, and that value is returned as a result of a bitwise NOT operation. Now let's see how the bitwise AND operation can be applied using the example. Bitwise AND is a binary operator, so we need 2 different operands. I am considering A and B with the values 10 and 5. So 10 and 5 I am going to apply. So in that case, first A and B are converted to the binary equivalent forms, and then the bitwise AND operation is applied on the corresponding bits of A and B. So if you consider, AND operation results in a 1 value whenever the corresponding digits of A and B both are 1, otherwise it returns a true value. So in this case, so in every position it is returning a zero value, and the final result is converted to equivalent integer value, which is actually a zero, so it returns that value. So now let's see how an OR operation can be applied. So for applying the bitwise OR operation, we have the operator pipeline symbol. So this is the OR operation we can apply. So A or B, that is 10 or 5. Actually these values A and B are converted to the binary equivalent forms, and we all know that. So OR operation returns a true value or a 1 value when either of the bits are 1. In all the other cases it's a 0. That is, when both are zeros, then only it returns a 0, otherwise it's a 1 only. So that's how in the last 4 digits it's returning a 1, and because both places are zeros in the first 4 digits, so it's returning a 0 value. Then that binary format is converted to the integer form, and then it's returning a 15 value. So now let's see how the XOR operation, bitwise XOR operation, can be applied. And to designate that XOR operation, we have the caret symbol. In some programming languages, it designates the exponentiation operation. So we can use A XOR B, 10 XOR 5. So again, so similar to the AND and OR operators, first the operands are converted to the binary form, and then the operation is applied. And we all know that for the XOR operation, it results in a 1 value when either of the bits are a 1, otherwise when both are zeros or both are 1s, in that case it results in a 0 value. So that is how the value is computed, and its equivalent integer form is returned as a result of this XOR operation. So in addition to the AND, OR, NOT, so these bitwise operations, we have the shift operators also that are supported by Python. Python actually supports 2 different shifts, the left shift and the right shift. So general form you can observe, so the number greater than followed by an integer value, and similarly with the left shift you can use number less than n, which indicates the left shift operation. And when you use these kind of shifting, then so actually Python shifts the number that you provided by n bits, either towards the right or towards the left, depending on the shift you are using. So basically you need to remember one point here: shift operator preserves the sign bit when it is shifting the bits towards the right or towards the left. So consider the left shift operation. So I am considering a value as 10, and on its binary format, so the operation is performed, so I am considering its equivalent binary form. So I am going to shift A by 2 bits. So shift A towards the left by 2 bits. So that's how I am using the left shift operator, less than, A less than 2. That indicates that, so A value is 10, so 10 less than 2. So in this case, I am going to shift the bits in A towards the left by 2 bits. So how it applies? So you can understand this. The bits are moved towards the left by 2 bits, and that resultant value is converted to integer, and its integer equivalent is 40. So that's how it returns a 40 as a result. Let's consider now the right shift operation. So for the right shift operation, so we use the greater than symbols. So A greater than 2, which indicates 10 greater than 2. So actually A is converted to binary form, and then we are going to apply right shift operation. Instead of the left shift, now we are applying the right shift. We are moving the bits towards the right. So because the number indicates 2, so the shifting is done by 2 bits. So after shifting the value in the binary form, so the resultant is converted to integer, and that will be returned as a result of the bitwise right shift operation, and in this case it's a 2 value. So now in this case we need to understand a few things. So whenever we are applying the right shift operation on a number by n bits, actually it is equivalent to the division of that number by 2 power n. And similarly, when we are applying the left shift operation on a number by n bits, then it's equivalent to applying the multiplication of that number with the 2 power n. So consider this example. So 20 right shift 2, that is, I am going to shift the number 20 by 2 bits towards the right. So it's actually equivalent to dividing the number by 2 power 2. So which is nothing but 5. So both results in the same value. And similarly, when you are applying the left shift operation, then it's equal to multiplying that value with 2 power that number of bits, how many ever number of bits you are shifting. So you are multiplying that number into 2 power the number of bits. So 20 left shift 2 is 80, and similarly 20 into 2 power 2 is also 80. So both results in the same values. So that's how bitwise shift operators equivalent to the division operation and the multiplication operation. So far in this lecture, we have discussed various operators that are supported by Python, and in detail we have discussed the arithmetic operators, then various relational operators, logical operators, and even the bitwise operators. So how the operations can be performed in terms of the bits in Python, and what are the operators that are available, the symbols that are available in Python to do all these kinds of operations, we have discussed so far. And in the next lecture, we'll discuss some more operators in detail. So thank you for watching this video.